Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know that is what is a ionic bond, and we have also discussed about the few examples where the ionic bond has been forming, and that was an example that we have talked over, like NaCl and that is CaCl2. And now we are going toward the next one, or the next type of bond, that is covalent bond. So what is actually covalent bond and how the bond formation takes place? So we'll take it with the help of an example. So let us understand it. So now we are going to discuss about covalent bond. So what is actually covalent bond? Let us understand it with the help of the definition of it, and we'll take an example for that. So talking about the first one, that is the attractive force which exists due to the mutual sharing of electrons between the two atoms of similar electronegativities or having small difference in their electronegativities is called as covalent bond. So basically covalent bond is a bond that has been formed between the two atoms which have basically almost same electronegativities, or there should be a difference, but it should not be that much, only a small kind of difference that should be there in their electronegativities, and then only we could say that the covalent bond has been formed. And moreover, the main theme of this to form the bond is basically it is not transfer of electron like the ionic bond that we have discussed earlier. It is basically sharing of the electrons. So here in this case, basically electrons are being shared by the two atoms, and so as to also complete the octet also, as well as to get a stable electronic configuration, and that is how a covalent bond has been formed. So talking about this thing, as we have discussed about earlier one, that is ionic bonds are basically shown by those substances which consist of a metal and a non-metal, while the covalent one it consists of this kind of bonds are being observed by the atoms which are basically non-metals, and that's the reason that the covalent bond has been formed, because of their less electronegativity difference between them. And let me clear it with the help of an example that I am going to talk about, but it plays a very important role, and let us understand it. So for that, I'm going to discuss about how the formation of covalent bond takes place, and I'm taking an example of, suppose if I want to give an example like chlorine molecule. So I could say, so formation of Cl2, and in this case, I'm not going to discuss about how the chlorine atom has been formed chemically by various processes, like the thing that we have did in the Born-Haber cycle of the formation of NaCl. But now we are coming back to the direct thing, that how the bond has been formed and which kind of bond has been formed between the chlorine atoms, and that is what we are going to discuss over here. So let us consider that the chlorine is the one that we have, and suppose two chlorine that we have, and among that the one which is basically, I will try to go over here. So obviously, we know that the electronic configuration of the chlorine can be written, because of which we know the atomic number of chlorine also, and that is basically 17. So if I write this, then I could get the electronic configuration that could be written as, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, and 3p5. Or else I could write it in this way also, that is, I could write it 2, 8, that is 7. So this is what we could write about the chlorine, and this is chlorine 17. So similarly, as we could see that the outermost shell or the outermost orbit consists of basically 7 electrons, and that's the reason that we could represent this chlorine atom in this manner, that is, which has basically 7 electrons in its outermost shell, and that could be written as in this way, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So these are the 7 electrons that are present in the outermost shell. And similarly, we could also make another chlorine and having the same thing. So even it will have the same electronic configuration, and obviously we are taking the same atoms over here. So the electronegativity of the chlorine will be the same in both the cases, and that's the reason that there will be no kind of electronegativity difference between the two atoms, and that's the reason that it is the main reason that the chlorine will form, that is covalent bond. So let us understand it. So this was the electronic configuration that has represented for a chlorine, and let us do the interaction of these two chlorine atoms. So as we have discussed earlier also, that is, the chlorine atom can be represented in this way, that I am going to represent, which consists of basically 7 electrons in its outermost shell. So therefore, this is the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, and this is the 7th. And this has an electronic configuration that could be written as 2, 8, 7. So talking about the another one, so even the another one will have, that is, the same electronic configuration, And we could write it in this way. That is, I'm going to represent it this way. That is, this is the chlorine atom that we have. And for this, I'm representing the number of electrons. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So these are the 7 electrons that are present in the outermost shell. So even I could give its electronic configuration, that could be written as 2, 8, 7. But we have did octet rule also. And in octet rule, we have got to know that if the outermost, every atom tries to acquire a stable electronic configuration, or basically could say like octet rule. So since, as you could see that both of the chlorine atoms that have basically 7 electrons in their outermost shell, and they need only 1 electron so as to get a complete electronic configuration, or you could say a stable electronic configuration. And this will behave like an noble gas, because noble gas have an electronic configuration which is very much stable. And that's the reason that they have 1 electron that could be shared. So suppose if this chlorine atom, which has a 1 electron, it has 7 electrons. So suppose if it share its electron to the another chlorine. So now this chlorine will become 2, 8, 8. So meanwhile, suppose if this should have to be like a stable electronic configuration, obviously this electron of the chlorine, which I have represented with in red ink, that will represent that will give its electron to the chlorine, which is of the green ink that I have represented over here. So meanwhile, even this chlorine will convert into an electronic configuration, that is 2, 8, 8. So obviously both are basically, they have the capability to become a stable electronic configuration. So that's the reason that these electrons, they can be shared. They can be shared between these two atoms, and that is the reason that the covalent bond can be formed. And we know that it happens because of the mutual sharing of electrons, and that is how it will form. So the representation could be done in this manner. So I am representing it over in this way. Suppose if they both come close to each other. So this is how the representation can be done. So I could write it in this way also. That is, this is the chlorine that we have, which consists of 7 electrons in its outermost shell. So I'm representing it again, just as to make understand that how the bond forms. And this is how, this is the electron of the chlorine that I have represented over here. And meanwhile, suppose I'm talking about the another chlorine that comes in contact with this chlorine atom. So therefore, this is the one that has, I'm representing it over here. This is the chlorine that I'm representing over here, which has also 7 electrons. So therefore, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So if you observe this thing, suppose if I have made such an arrangement where I could see that both the atoms can acquire 8 electrons in their outermost shell or in their electronic configuration. Suppose if I have made it the arrangement in this way. So here you could see, suppose if this is the outermost orbit, then I could see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. 8 electrons are being acquired by this chlorine atom, making this to be having an electronic configuration of, that is 2, 8, 8. And this is how it will behave like argon. But talking about this chlorine atom, again this chlorine atom can have an electronic configuration that is 2, 8, because like this one. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, 8 electrons are present in its outermost shell. Now this, even this could be behave like 2, 8, 8, and that is like argon. Argon 18. So this is how the electrons are being shared, because obviously this electron, as I have made it over here, this is of this one, while this green one or this electron is of the another chlorine. So this is how the bond forms between these two, and the both are having a now stable electronic configuration, just like the argon 18. And that is how they stabilize each other by sharing their electrons, and this is how the bond forms. So I could represent in this way, that is, if I'm talking about the bond, then this 6 are the electrons that are being not forming a bond. Basically these are the we could also say as unpaired electrons, while that of this are the one that helps so as to form the bond between them. So that's the reason that whenever a chlorine forms a bond with another chlorine, it forms a single bond. And this single bond represents the electrons, that is one electron is of this chlorine while this electron is of another chlorine, and they both are shared with each other. And since the both are having the same atom, and we could say that they have the same electronegativity, so this is a kind of sharing of electrons, and we could see that is this one is basically that is a covalent bond. So this was an example that I have talked about, but both the atoms were same in this example, and even we could do the same thing with that of if I take a hydrogen molecule. So even the hydrogen molecule will share that share its electrons so as to become like a noble gas like helium. But helium is the one that doesn't follow the octet rule, but still it is the most stable one, having the two electrons in its outermost shell. So obviously hydrogen will also will behave like that of helium if it share its electron with the other one, or it takes the electron from the other one. So therefore it will behave like an noble gas. So this one was the one which has also followed the octet rule. Again, it was showing a stable electronic configuration. So now let me give another example where we could see a small difference between the electronegativities and how they can form that is covalent bond. So let us talk about it. So in this example, I'm going to talk about the formation of CH4, that is methane, or the formation of bond between the carbon and the hydrogen. And let us talk about this one. So the first is I want to talk about the carbon, because carbon is the central atom of this whole molecule, that is CH4. And talking about the electronic configuration of carbon, the carbon can be represented in this way, that is if I represent about carbon. So carbon has an atomic number of 6, so I could write it as 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, or else I could write it as 2, 4. So even this is the electronic configuration that I could represent about the carbon. And talking about the hydrogen, so hydrogen is the one that could be represented in this way, that is hydrogen, which has an atomic number of 1, that could be represented as 1s1. So again, the outermost shell of the carbon consists of the hydrogen consists of one electron. But talking about the stability, that how can the carbon be more stable, or it will have an electronic configuration very much similar to that of the noble gas, if either it donates 4 electron or if it takes 4 electron. So that is how now we are going to talk about carbon and hydrogen. So because now when we compare it with the carbon and hydrogen, so they have almost the same electronegative, not almost, I would say they will have, obviously they will have a difference, because these two atoms are not very much same to each other. And that's the reason that there will have at least a difference between the electronegativities, but not like a huge difference, just like if we talk about NaCl. So NaCl is basically ionic compound, and obviously there will be difference in their electronegativities. While talking about the sodium, it is more electropositive. I talk about the chlorine atom, it is more electronegative. So obviously there is a appreciable difference that we could find out. But when it comes to the difference or electronegative difference between the carbon and hydrogen, so it is not the appreciable, or we can't say that the difference is too much. And that is how the covalent bond takes place. And let me talk about this, how the bond will take place over here. And so before that, I could represent the carbon in this manner, that is the carbon which consists of 4 electrons in its outermost shell. So that could be written as in this way. So this is the first electron, second, third, fourth. So 4 electrons are being on the outermost orbit of the carbon over here, as we could see over here. And talking about the hydrogen, hydrogen has an basically 1 electron in its outermost shell. I am representing it with a dot. So these are the things that I'm going to represent. And so the thing that I have to do is I have to combine 4 hydrogens to that of only single carbon. And let us see that how the bond takes place over here. So since carbon is the one which is present in the center of the molecule, so I would represent the carbon in such a way, that is the carbon which consists of basically 4 electrons in its outermost shell. So this is the first electron, second, third, and this is the fourth. And we are talking about the hydrogen. Hydrogen has the 1 electron in its outermost shell. So therefore I could represent it in this way also. That is, this is the hydrogen that we have, and this is the electron of the hydrogen. While another hydrogen is also, there will be, it will be there between this. And even this is the hydrogen which has 1 electron, and this is the hydrogen which has 1 electron. So therefore this is basically the Lewis structure that I have, or the electronic structure of the methane that I have drawn over here. But during the bond formation, obviously in its outermost shell, that should acquire a 4 electrons so as to form basically a stable electronic configuration. So I could represent this structure, because obviously there would be sharing of electrons, because suppose if I'm talking about it in this way, that is, if carbon will accept this electron, so it has four originally, but if by taking one electron, it will have five electrons in its outermost shell, six electrons in its outermost shell, seven electrons, and ultimately eight electrons in its outermost shell. So making this to be like behaving like a noble gas. And meanwhile, hydrogen also will, because we are talking about the covalent bond, and both that is the hydrogen and carbon, they don't have electronegativity difference. So therefore, even hydrogen will have the capability to share the electron toward itself of the carbon. So it will take the electron of the carbon, and now the hydrogen will behave like helium, and that is how the both will share electrons, so as to get a stable electronic configuration, and that is how the covalent bond takes place. So this is just a representation of the electronic structure of the methane, but to make it understand, let me introduce another structure so that we could represent that how the bond takes place over here. So again, I'm going to represent it in such a way that where I could see that the carbon has four electrons in its outermost shell. I'm just making out a space over here so that we could represent in a very nice manner. And talking about the next one, that is the hydrogen. So the hydrogen is the one which consists of one electron in its outermost shell. So I'm representing it over here. And again, here it would be a hydrogen. It would be here. And again, hydrogen I have represented. So the electron would be here. And again, an hydrogen. So the electron would be here. So if you observe the outermost shell of the carbon, so initially it consisted of four electrons when it was in an atomic state. When it is forming a molecule, and that is how we could see that the total number of electrons in its outermost shell is now, because of the sharing of electrons, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is 8. So there are basically 8 electrons in its outermost shell. So this is how I could represent the outermost shell of the carbon as 8. So 8 electrons are present in its outermost shell, and now this is how the carbon is behaving like the one which has in like neon, if I would say. So neon is the one which has basically 10 electrons, and that is how the carbon has an outermost electron now to be called as 8 electrons. So therefore 2,8, that is making it to be called as neon. So it is behaving like a noble gas. But talking about the hydrogen, so hydrogen serves, this hydrogen is the one which has one electron. And this will share the electron of the carbon atom. So this is over here. So here is what we could see, that the carbon which accepts an electron of the hydrogen accepts the electron of the carbon, so as to become now like helium. Again, it is behaving like a noble gas. Again, this hydrogen is also the same thing, that it will happen over here. And for every hydrogen, they will share their electrons, and this is how the bond formation takes place and the covalent bond is formed. So that's the reason that we always write the structure of methane in such a manner that they are not only, so they not only make a stable electronic configuration, but the valency is also being maintained over here, and this is how the bond forms, and that bond is basically a covalent bond. So this is how I was representing the formation of equivalent bonds with the help of an examples, and that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have understood the concept behind this, and I hope you'll share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.